Hello students, once again welcome back to the class of physics. So in the previous session actually we discussed the concept of what happens if voltage AC voltage applied to a resistor, capacitor as well as inductor, the derivation part that we have done. So but there we got a few new concepts, like there we resistor is already well known for all of you, but but you don't know what do you mean by inductive reactance as well as capacitive reactance. So that is a new word for you people, but we'll see what do you mean by inductive reactance as well as what will be the power if you can take power in a purely inductive circuit as well as power in a purely capacitive circuit. So before going to that, actually once I already discussed, but I'm just recalling that this concept again. What does it mean? See, inductive reactance is nothing but it is the one in which it opposes the flow of AC current in an inductive circuit. In other words, we can define it as it is the opposition offered by the inductance in an alternating current. If we consider the inductive circuit, that is nothing but it's a kind of opposition offered by this particular inductor. Okay, so opposition offered in the case of inductor. So what happens, it will oppose the flow of AC current through the inductor circuit, purely inductive circuit. But and also we know the symbolic representation of this inductive reactance, that is represented by XL. So how do you define this as? You can write it as omega into L. So omega means what? You already know, that is 2 pi by T into L. So what do you mean by 2 pi? I'll write as it is. We know that 1 by T is nothing but what? It is nothing but nu, or you can write it as F into L, or you can also write it as 2 pi nu into L. Anything if is fine. Just go through with that. In a purely inductive circuit, what we can say, see, inductive reactance is proportional to what? Nu. That means what? Because L is nothing but inductor that we already taken there, so that is that you leave. So only the one variable here is nothing but nu. What happens if frequency changes? If frequency increases, then obviously there is a increase in the value of inductive reactance. So these two are directly proportional. So the frequency increases, the inductive reactance is also goes on increases. But if frequency is zero, then what happens to the L? So XL value, that is also become XL, or sometimes used like it as L, depends. Okay, symbolic representation, anything you can take and you can explain. So in purely inductive circuit, so what happens, the frequency is zero, then obviously the inductive reactance is zero. What is the meaning of this? So it means that there is no opposition in that particular circuit. Okay, so this will be the meaning of inductive reactance. We know the formula and also the meaning. Next, we need to find the value of power in purely inductive circuit. So what will be the value of power? For example, let us take, we know the expression for power, that is equal to V into I. So V into I. So what is the value of V? V, you already know, that is given by V is equal to V naught sine omega t. Here I value we got in the previous video, you just go and watch, you will get the value. So I is equals to what? I naught sine of omega t minus pi by 2. So when you substitute these two values here in this equation, so what you will get? So P is equals to V naught sine omega t into I naught sine of omega t minus pi by 2, sine of omega t minus pi by 2. So that is given by V naught into I naught sine omega t into what is the value of sine of omega t minus pi by 2, or we can write in the previous derivation only we derived that. Correct. Sine of omega t minus pi by 2. It is nothing but what? Minus cos omega t. That means sine of theta minus pi by 2 in general. So sine of pi by 2 minus theta is what? Cos theta. So if you take minus outside, what you will get? Theta minus pi by 2. So minus cos theta already there. So you will get minus cos theta. So that is given by V naught into I naught sine omega t into cos omega t. We know that. What? Sine of 2 theta. Sine 2 theta is equals to what? 2 sine theta cos theta. So send this 2 here. What you will get? Sine 2 theta by 2 is equals to sine theta into cos theta. Just replace sine in the place of theta as omega t. So when you replace that, and if you write, wait a minute, let me check. You can't see here. So I'll erase this. Okay, now what you will get here, so sorry, minus we left, minus into this, you will get minus. So P is equals to minus V naught into I naught. You can write it as sine 2 omega t. Can we write like that? Yes, we can. Omega t by 2. Or we can write sine of minus I naught into V naught by 2 into sine 2 omega t. Now we need to find the value of average power. So in the resistive circuit, there we actually found the value of that. So here it's an inductive circuit, the same procedure. But there what we took, in one complete cycle, what would be the value of average power? That is what we need to find out here. So average power during the time interval from where to where? 0 to t, which is given by, so p is equals to, we need to do what? We need to do the integration. So when you do the integration, so what you will get? So p bar is equals to integration of minus 0 to t V naught I naught divided by 2 into sine 2 omega t into, actually here there is no term dt, so for that what we need to do is just multiply and divided by integration of dt, where the time interval from 0 to t. So then what you will get? 0 to t integration of dt. Here you can write there also dt. So integration of dt is what? That is equals to, it is nothing but t only. Okay, we can keep t as it is. Then so take the common terms first, minus v naught I naught divided by 2t. So integration of dt is what? It is nothing but t only. Can write as it is, into integration of sine of 2 omega t into dt. So when you further integrate this, so what you will get? Average power p is equals to minus v naught I naught divided by 2t into, so integration of sine 2 omega t is what? Cos 2 omega t divided by 2 omega, where the t varies from 0 to t. So not the t, actually it is the time interval. So the limits varies from 0 to t. So take this 2 omega outside. What you get? Minus v naught I naught. Sorry. Sine of integration of sine 2 omega t is what? Minus cos 2 omega t. So minus minus will get cancelled. Then you will get plus here. Here there is no minus 2 omega t into, now you can apply the limits. So cos of omega 2, already there omega value is what, 2 pi by t, upper limit is t, into t minus cos 2, okay, cos 0, okay, leave. So t d will get cancelled. Cos of 2 into 2 pi, that is 4 pi. Cos 4 pi value is what, v naught I naught divided by 2 omega t into cos 4 pi value is what, it is cos, it comes around 0 only. So cos 0 is what, the value is 1 here, minus cos 0 is value is what, 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0, so the whole term become 0. So the average power here, what you will get, it is nothing but 0. Okay, so what does it state here? See, the average power supplied in an inductor over one complete cycle is 0. The average power supplied to an inductor in one complete cycle is 0. So this is the meaning of inductive reactance and power consumed in purely inductive circuit. What is the power in purely inductive circuit? It is nothing but 0. Okay, they may ask in your exam, they will ask find the inductive reactance and also some other parameter. Along with that, they may ask you to find the value of average power. So if you take the average power, that value will become 0. Okay, so you no need to find out the value of average power there in a given numerical. If they ask, you just write directly the value of average power as 0. Okay, so that you can save your time. Okay, so this is all about the inductor and the inductive reactance and also the power. So in the next, we are going to find out what will be the value of capacitive reactance, and what do you mean by capacitive reactance, and what will be the power consumed in the case of capacitive reactance. Okay, so once again, welcome back. So as I told you, here in this video, we are going to study what is the meaning of capacitive reactance and what are the formula that we are going to get under this, and also what will be the power in purely capacitive circuit. Okay, so see, when you look at this, as we discussed in the previous concept, the same thing here also. Here also, capacitive reactance is nothing but it's a kind of opposition offered by the capacitor which you have taken in the circuit. So in other words, we can say it as the capacitive reactance is the effective opposition offered by the capacitance to altering current in the circuit. Okay, it's a kind of opposition offered in the purely capacitive circuits. You just remember like that. Okay, it's a kind of opposition for the AC current. Now, so what will be the value? How we are going to find the value of capacitive reactance? And it is represented by XC. And we can write it as 1 over omega C. We can also write it as 1 over 2 pi F into C. Or we can write this as 2 pi nu into C. Why, sir? See, we can write 1 over omega is what? 2 pi by t into C, already there. So 1 over 2 pi into 1 by t value is what? That is nu or F into C. We can write like that. So this is how we are going to find the value of capacitive reactance. It is nothing but it's a kind of opposition offered in the alternating current. Okay, so in a capacitive circuit, where this capacitive reactance is inversely proportional to what? Frequency. As the frequency goes on increases, then what happens with the capacitive reactance? It goes on decreases. If the frequency goes on decreases, this capacitive reactance goes on increases. That means by decreasing the frequency, the opposition offered by this is more. Okay, if you increase the frequency, this will goes on decreases. In other words, if the value of nu is 0, then what will be the value of XC? So XC is nothing but it is infinity. So infinite opposition that we are going to get if you keep the value of frequency as zero. In another words, we can say this will block DC if the frequency of that AC circuit is zero. Okay, then it will block DC. That's the reason what it means gives that capacitive reactance is infinite. Okay, infinity. That means it produces more opposition to the flow of AC current. So now we need to find the value of what? We need to find the value of power in purely capacitive circuit. So what the procedure we have followed in the previous case, the same procedure we need to adopt here also. So what we can write, power is equals to what? V into I. We know what is the value of V. Let me write once again. V is equals to V naught sine omega t, and I is equals to what? I naught sine omega t plus pi by 2. Okay, here only I'll write that it is nothing but cos omega t. So though if we write here only, then we can reduce more number of steps. So next, you substitute both the values of V and I in this equation of power, then what you will get? V is equals to what? V naught sine omega t into I naught cos omega t, that is equals to V naught into I naught sine omega t into cos omega t. We know that in the previous problem only I wrote the formula, that is sine omega t into cos omega t is equals to what? Sine of 2 omega t by 2. So this will be the formula. I'll write here, we know that. If you write that here, so what you will get? V naught into I naught divided by 2 into sine of 2 omega t. This is for what? P, power. So if you want to find the value of average power in this purely capacitive circuit, okay, then what we can write? Average power P is equals to, can be written as, in one complete cycle will be given as 0 to t V naught into I naught divided by 2 into sine 2 omega t. There is no term dt here. You can write dt whole divided by integration of 0 to t into dt. Okay, I'll write one more step. I'll simplify the things. So V naught I naught by 2 is common. Take it outside. V naught into I naught divided by 2. Integration of dt is what? T. When you apply the limits, you'll get t minus 0. That is t only into. So integration of sine 2 omega t into dt. I'll write one more step. Sine 2 omega t into dt. So when we integrate this, what we will get? That is given by P is equals to V naught I naught divided by 2 T into cos sine of omega t is what? That is minus cos omega t cos omega, sorry, cos 2 omega t divided by 2 omega, where the limits varies from 0 to t. That is given by minus V naught into I naught divided by 2 omega t, because I'll take it outside, you'll get 4 omega t into cos 2 into, what is the value of omega? That is 2 pi by t into, upper limit is t, minus cos 2 omega into 0. You'll get cos 0 only, because 2 omega into 0 is what? 0. Why 0, sir? Because we have applied lower limit. So which is given by TT will get cancelled. So minus V naught I naught divided by 4 omega T into cos 4 pi. What is the value? That is equals to 1. So minus cos 0 value is what? That is also equals to 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So this whole term becomes 0. So then the average power here in purely capacitive circuit, that is also equals to 0. Okay, so this is what actually we are supposed to get here in this case. So the average power in a purely capacitive circuit, this value in a one complete cycle. Okay, or the average power supplied to a purely capacitive circuit in one complete cycle, that is equals to zero. Okay, so if you remember these concepts, you can easily write the answer in your given exam. If they ask to find out the average power in inductive as well as capacitive circuit, so what is the value of that? That is equals to zero. Whatever may be the frequency, whatever may be the angular velocity and current or maybe voltage, doesn't matter. Why? Because that final term, when you integrate, then definitely you will get the value as zero only, because we are going to consider one complete cycle. If you consider half cycle, there it might be a different value. So that we will discuss while solving the numerical. So this is all up to alternating voltage applied to an inductor, capacitor as well as resistor. So finally we will get this result. Hope you all understood. Just go through with these concepts. Okay, if you have any doubt, just ask your doubts in a group so that we can discuss there. Okay, so write down and please do maintain proper notes. Okay, maybe after this video I'm going to solve few numericals so that you can easily understand how way to apply all these formulas. Okay, you must remember these formulas because we are going to solve the numericals in the next video. Okay.